Okay, I will start by introducing myself. I'm Denise Gagne. I'm the creator of Musicplay and musicplayonline.com, and I'm half of the Artie and Denise team that's doing a wonderful virtual conference July 14th to 16th. If you're interested, we'll give you some information on that. You can sign up at musicplayusa.com, or you can sign up at musicplaycanada.com, depending on which country you're from. I want to introduce a few of my team members here. Carrie Lynn Giveaways. Carrie Lynn is our operations manager. She's the one that manages the whole team, and she's wonderful, much better manager than I am. Karis Giveaways. Karis is a wonderful graphic designer, and she's our moderator today. Serge, give us a wave. Serge is our French translator. I don't know how many of you have noticed that we do have a substantial body of work on the website in French. And Serge is ensuring that we have a lot more. We're going to have a complete French music curriculum for our students. Shannon, give us a wave. Shannon is our Renaissance woman. Shannon does everything from music and singing and bassoon and the whole works. And Danae is our newest team member. Soon we're going to have a new one because we've got another programmer and we're all excited. So this is our team. I've been teaching since 1978, and some days it feels like it's forever, and I'm not sure I'm ever actually going to retire. I think I'll probably be doing this part-time till the day I die, but I have not been able to teach this year. Normally, I guest teach quite a bit in our local schools, and because of COVID this year, I have been completely shut out, but I've got some wonderful ideas for you for subtubs. So I'm going to share my screen and show you the very, very easiest sub plan ever. And I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to go to beta.musicplayonline.com. This site is going to be not beta in the fall. As of June 30th, this is going to be musicplayonline.com. So if you haven't been here yet, try it out, go to the dashboard, generate your class code. Links to your students will include the code automatically, but it's really, really handy. And webinars are recorded and stored here. So when you come to your dashboard, if you've missed a webinar, you can check it out. And it's under announcements, Carrie Lynn. Give me a thumbs up or down.
Yes, it is.
It's under announcements. So there's the previous webinars. But I'm going to take you to the learning modules, which I want to rename lesson modules, because these are the easiest plan ever. You give your substitute teacher your student access code that you get from the dashboard, and then they go to whatever grade module it is. So I was going to go way back to the beginning of the year to grade one, lesson four, and show you how easy it is for a sub to do a lesson for you. It tells them what they're going to do. You have the I can statements. You have the lesson guide. You can print it out and leave it for the sub if you want. It's not really needed because it follows very closely what's here. So we have number one, sing the echoes and welcome to music. I'm a non-music sub. I can press play on the recording. And let's do the echoes.
Welcome to music. Welcome to music.
Glad you're here.
Glad you're here.
A non-music sub can do that as easily as you can. And we have an Echo Bobo. For those of you that haven't met Bobo.
Boys and girls, this is my Bobo. And my Bobo's gonna sing, and I want you to sing that to her.
Bobo.
And we echo. And so again, sub doesn't have to sing, they can just do it. Now we have a move to the beat activity. So
plus,
I don't know if we can do this.
Some music.
We can try and sitting. We might have to stand up.
With no introduction. So we're going to start with our hands up.
Okay, hands up. I love copying myself. This is so much fun. And down. everybody's joining us for their little fitness moment. And we can escape and we can create new ways to do the music. We can learn about Mozart. I won't go through the video, but it's a little short video, 2 minutes and 46 seconds, about Mozart. We can play instruments with the song Apples and Bananas. So we're going to sing it first, and then we're going to play it. We actually have for this song, yes, it's this song, a brand new interactive activity in the song list. So if I click here, I don't know if it's going to be there or not, but I'm going to just take a chance and see if it is. And it is. Oh, no, it isn't. Okay, so I lied. I'll have to go back. But that whole lesson goes step by step by step. I might have to go back into my learning modules. I messed myself up. And I want lesson number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I was on Apples and Bananas and thought I would show you something new, but it's not there. Did I do lesson 4? Oh, that's
back to school. Yeah.
Back to school. Yeah, that's where I'm wrong. So let's go back to my search. And grade 1 is there. And then I want, not that, I want this one. We have to include lessons for August because many of our American teachers are back in school already the first week of August. And it didn't align with my Music Play Teacher's Guide. So I basically built extra lessons for August. And whatever week you start in August, you can start in those lessons. For those that start in September, you can start right here in the September lessons. So there's Bobo. There's moving to Mozart, learning about Mozart, playing instruments with Apples and Bananas. And then we sing and do the actions for the counting song. This is so simple. Lots of people know. 1, 2, tie my shoe. 3, 4, shut the door. But if you have a sub who doesn't, here's the demo so that they can learn to do them. And then we're going to sing and point to the higher and lower notes. 1, 2, tie my shoe. If they're projecting, they point on the screen to those higher and lower notes. And that, again, pretty simple. Make an alphabet pointing page. And actually, I've got one behind me here because we're going to do an alphabet activity that's non-technology. But make an alphabet pointing page. And we're going to use that with the song Rock Around the Alphabet. So it's A, B, C, O, baby, D, E, F, O, baby. So we have the Canadian version with Z and the American version with Z. So we use both letter Z and letter Z. Play the loud quiet game. And so this is a game. And again, with the interactive links, it's pretty easy to go to the game and play it. We're gonna start. Turn my sound even louder so it, that one was a loud sound. Another loud sound. I'd have the kids keep the beat while they're doing it. I think that's a loud, ooh, I did it wrong. It was a quiet one. And that's a loud one. And that one's a quiet one. Loud one. Nice loud one. There we have a nice quiet one. And yes, I got 2 wrong sounds, not just 1. I can just click out of the loud quiet game. We have a storybook, So Me Goes Missing. And these are on the website. Again, 6 minutes of story. I always echo each time I hear So Me, so I pause the video. And then the music time is over. So it's really easy for a substitute teacher to work through these modules. And if you are able to give them access via the student code to the module, they can work through this. So here's the learning module for an upper grade. I'm gonna look grade 5, and I'm actually going to look at lesson 38. This is last week's lesson that I built. It's actually this week's lesson. I built it last week, and it's a music genres activity, and the first slide shows what to do. A genre is a style or category of music. Your sub doesn't have to know that. They can read it. Some popular genres include pop, blues, jazz, rhythm and blues, rock, country, soul, and dance music. Can you think of others? Involve a discussion with the kids. Listen to the musical example, and based on how much you like listening to it, rate it 1 to 4. If you can, give a brief response. There is a student worksheet that you can print and leave in your sub tub. I have my sub tub here. I have folders in here for each grade. So if I was planning on using this as a substitute lesson plan, I would photocopy enough for all my grade fives, all my grade sixes, maybe even all my grade fours, and leave it in my sub tub. You might need 2 sub tubs, 1 for K to 2 and 1 for 3 to 6, if you're doing a lot of copying and preparing. Or teachers could just discuss it, but this worksheet is handy. It really keeps the kids focused. So that's the worksheet. And then what they do is they listen to each example and they rate it.
We have played at this exact venue a handful of times. Beautiful community, it's a music loving town, and you can feel that so much in the fans that come to the shows. I love it here.
I think she's talking about Atlanta. So please put in the chat where you're from so we can see if we have anybody from Atlanta with us today.
You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug. You can be the outcast or be the backlash of somebody's lack of love.
So all the examples in this have been run through SafeShare, so there isn't ads, and she is live from Atlanta. And you can discuss the genre. In the teacher's notes, I did put the answers. So, and again, there might be some ambiguity, whether it's rock, classic rock, I'm sure you could have discussions about that forever. But these examples are really, really fun. Example 2, let's see if it goes faster. I've also had to relink these examples quite a lot because they worked and until they didn't. So it looks like example 2 isn't working for me. I'll have to go back and redo that one. And then example 3, let's see if that one pops up for us. Oh, this isn't good. Oh, there it is. I have a clue that this is going to be an older song. And the kids are asked to put in the artist and the title. So if they're clever, they'll see this at the top. So I have lots of fun picking out 15 examples. If 1 or 2 don't work, just go on to the next one. But this is, again, this is a great sub plan for a non-music sub. Even a music sub is going to have fun doing these. So I'm going to stop sharing and I'm going to talk to you about some non-music lesson plans. On the website, and I probably should actually go back and show you where these come from. We have a whole set of lessons for non-technology. And that's because my daughter, actually, she's a music teacher in Calgary. And in her school, giving teachers access to her technology is really difficult when they come in to guest teach in her classroom or to sub in her classroom. So I will show you where these are. On the beta.musicplayonline, you go to lesson planning. And then I go to the grade level. So I'll go to kindergarten. And here are the no touch sub activities that I have in my hand. So that's them. Really good ideas. They're what she's used all year. These lesson plans here are a second option. If you can give your teachers technology, here's a list of what I think are the most fun songs in Music Play for kindergarten, a list of the singing games, rhythm instrument activities, music listening activities, online games, create a big book. And then what the sub does, they put the date, they put the name, and then they check off any activities that they have completed. So you can print those out and put them into your sub tub And then when you have to be gone, you just put the stack on your desk of whatever grade levels the sub has to teach that day. And this way, the sub can look through the list and go, okay, Spider on the Floor, I know that song. And then all they have to do is to go to the website, search for the song, and they're in. But the sub themselves can choose based on what they feel comfortable doing in a music classroom. So those are in, I'll show you again. They are in lesson planning. Lesson planning is where I went. And then I go into this yellow button, planning resources. And here's my substitute plans for using the website. And these ones are for no technology, if you have that situation as well. So let's take a look at some of, let's look at the no tech first one first. So I have that list, and the activity that is first on that list, I'm gonna stop sharing so we can talk. The first activity is the Rhythm Jedi game. And so what you do is you spread your kids out as far as you can. You select one student who goes outside or hides their eyes really successfully. Turn their back on the class, hide their eyes so they can't peek. Then you select another student that is the leader, and they keep the beat on some part of their body. And the person that's outside or has their eyes closed comes back in, and they try and figure out who is the leader. Now, if I'm the leader, every time they turn their back on me, I'm going to change spots. And I'm going to try and do it subtly enough that they don't realize who I am. And eventually, the Rhythm Jedi is going to figure out who the leader is. And then you choose a new leader and you go on. This is a camp game. And so lots of people outside of the music world are familiar with it. But it's fun. And that's a good no-touch game. The ABC hide and play game. I have a whiteboard behind me, which is something new in my office. And what I'm going to do is go back here. And I'm presuming that every sub in the world can sing A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So they would sing the alphabet song with the kids, pointing to the letters as they go. And then what they ask the student, or what a student to do, is to come and erase a letter or two. I'm going to take up this one. So let's sing it now, and we hide that one in our head. Ready, go. A, B, C, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. And the next student comes up, and they erase something different. Let's take out two. And now we sing the song in our head. One, two, ready, go. A, B, C, E, F, G, H, K, L, M, N, O, P. And you could even have a student be the pointer. So you keep going until almost all the letters are gone. And then you point the beats, and the kids are singing the whole song inside their head. So that is a fun game. Freddy the Frog game is next, and it needs a frog. And again, that we've got the kids, because of COVID, spaced out as far as possible. One student goes out of the classroom, and another student helps you to hide the frog somewhere in the classroom. Again, because of COVID, only one person could touch this. That may disappear next year, but this is still a cute little game to play. So I'm going to hide the frog somewhere in my room in plain sight. And then what we do is we play an instrument, or we clap, or we pat, and we play louder as the student gets closer to it, and quieter when they're far away. So if I'm coming in from outside of the classroom, I'm hearing. Until I get here. So kids are not using shouty voices, they're not using voices at all because of COVID restrictions, but they're using a clapped beat instead. And on the lesson plan, she's got, you can review this as a review of dynamics terms. So the answers are all here for the sub. Even if I don't know what forte means, I can go, okay, students, what does forte mean? And it says right here, it means loud. So that'll be an easy way for them to review. Another one that she has in a set of lessons is the mystery box. And this is my mystery box. I got my preschoolers at one of my Montessori schools to paint this for me, and it's really lovely. I love what they've done. So in the mystery box, you select a variety of instruments from the tubs, and I've pre-done this to save us a little time. And then you play the instrument. So I'm gonna pick instruments. If I'm the sub and I'm not a music person, I'm gonna pick instruments that I kind of know what they are. So what's this one? A little bit of that can be seen. That was my sticks or my clavies. I think I would call them sticks. What's this one? This is for the music teachers. Put in the chat if you recognize what that instrument is. Oh, somebody's got it here. I see that Renee's got it. And it was my lovely ocean drum. Okay. A non-music sub might not pick that one, but a music sub certainly would enjoy showing that one to the kids. Okay, here's something a non-music sub could do. What's this one? Put it in the chat. And you got it. It is a tambourine. Okay, this one. I want the specific kind, because you're music teachers. In the chat, you know what that is. Oh, someone's got it. And it was an egg shaker. I had little ones, little three-year-olds that could tell the difference between egg shaker and raucous when I do mystery box with them. So the kids get really quite good at this one. Okay, so you can figure this one out. In the chat, what you think it is. Oh, and you are way too good at this. This is castanets. So that's a fun game. I really like to do this after I've introduced a few instruments with the little ones especially, and they learn those instrument names, they learn those instrument timbres, and it's a really, really good activity for them. So that is my mystery box. Instrument tic-tac-toe, and you need instrument flashcards for this. And I went and raided the shelves, and I found this instrument alphabet for it. But I'm sure most classrooms have some version of this. So what I'm going to do is we're going to have two teams, and we're going to play tic-tac-toe. So I show an instrument to team one, and I hide the name. The name's down at the bottom here, but I can show it and hide it. So put into the chat if you know what that is, team one. And I see accordion. You are exactly right. So you get to choose team one if you want to be the X or the O. So team one gets to be the X. Now I show team two. And you know what this one is? It's Shannon's favorite instrument. Yeah, that's a nice looking young man playing it too. So if you happen to know that that busker is playing the bassoon, oh, gets to fill it in. So again, everybody knows how to play X's and O's. And if you have a set of instrument flashcards, you could leave that in your sub-tub. That could be something that a sub could do with almost every grade. It's a good review of lots of different instruments. So simple, I think easy for subs to do, music or non-music, because the answers are on those flashcards. Number 8 on Stacy's list was the number concentration game. And because we haven't been allowed to sing all year in Alberta, I saw a question. What are the names of the flashcards? It's called the instrument alphabet. And if you go to musicplay.ca and select Canada or the US, you can get them. They're also available at West Music. So the number concentration game, this is a song in Music Play 3, but because we couldn't sing, she put in here to chant it as a poem. Don't forget your number. Don't forget your name. when you're ready, start the game. And so all the class would say that poem until they have learned it. Then you assign a number to each student in the class. So if I've got 20 kids, we've got 20 different numbers. So I say the poem, then I speak a number out loud, and the student speaks back their name. So let's say the poem together and we'll pretend we're playing. Don't forget your number, don't forget your name. When you're ready, start the game. One, Carrie Lynn. Two, three, Serge. Four, Shannon. Five, Michelle. Six, Susan. I usually do it in order the first time, and then I start mixing them up, and they have to really pay attention then. So these ideas are all in the lesson planning section of Musicplay Online. So those are great ideas. I didn't put this in my handout, but I'm going to say it early. Centers are another really good activity for substitute teachers. And this batch of rhythm dice games has 10 different games. My favorite is the scales and slides game. I have it made up as a center in my sub tub. Oops, that's the wrong game. So this is what I put into my sub tub. It comes with 25 dice. And really for each game, you only need one or two dice. You don't need 25, you don't need the 25 dice. But on occasion, those dice do go out of the rooms in the pockets of kids. So it's good to have extras. So in this game, if I'm playing against Michelle and Susan, Michelle would roll the dice. And if she got a whole note, she'd go one, two, three. Oh, start. One. That's the finish. This is the start. One, one, two, three, four. And if I rolled a half note, I'd go one, two. You can get it, make the game go faster by having the kids roll two dice and then they have to add them together. So faster is better for lots of kids. If I hit the bottom of a scale, I go up. But if I hit the top of a trombone, I slide down. So it's like chutes and ladders. And actually it's lots of fun. I've done this in grade three, grade four, grade five classrooms, worked really, really well. And that's why it's actually in my sub tub. Because when I guest teach, sometimes I'll take those along. Another game from the rhythm dice games, it's called Table Talk. I keep, when I do centers, I keep the little headers so that I can label the center. And in this one, what you do is you roll a dice. If I get a whole note, I can cross out whole note. I can cross out the note. I can cross out four beats and four time. Or I can cross out four, which is the time name I give to it. And so this is done for all the note values that are in the game. The kids play and the first one finished is the winner. The first one to cross everything on this page out. I like this game in third and in fourth because that's where I transition them from using ta and tt to knowing that it's a quarter note and it's one beat and four time. So this game helps with the transition. So both those games and eight more are in this rhythm dice games. Again, I know West Music has them. I'm pretty sure Music in Motion does if you're in the States. And if you're in Canada, musicplay.ca will get you that. My music teacher daughter has built two sets of super simple centers. And these really are well done. There's a version where all the centers are printed for you. This is really heavy. And there's a version where you can download and do your own printing that's less expensive. But these centers, again, are really, really good. So this one is kindergarten grade one. There's things like Play-Doh. You build the symbols out of Play-Doh. Kids really enjoy that. That would be, again, a great sub plan. Teachers don't have to, a non-music sub can do that. So the games are simple, really easily laid out. My daughter finds that really restful to do centers, and she likes to do that after she's done a holiday concert. Here's her grade two and three centers, and again, available both with the cards and materials already all printed, and they're printed in color. So, I mean, it's good value when you get the color printing done for you, or you can get the download version where you download it and print it. For older kits, these Music Center kits are very good as well. I had in my sub top. The tempo twister gig. So I keep in the package ready to go into my schools for school visits. I keep the game. And so this one, I've got the rhythm dice. Actually, these are regular dice here. They could be rhythm dice instead. And then they do a start and they roll and they have to be able to tell me what the term means. And if they get it right, they get to go on. If they get it wrong, they go back to where they were. That's tempo tornado. We've got markers. I've used little itty bitty erasers as our markers for the game. And then finally, for things that work really well, that are purchase products, orchestra bingo and classroom instrument bingo. These are both on musicplayonline.com. So you don't need to buy them if you're using the website and if your sub can get technology. But if you don't have access to the technology or you don't have a subscription to the website, this is the next best thing. So this comes with all the game cards to play orchestra bingo. I suggest this from about grade 2 and up, and then the classroom instrument bingo for grade kindergarten and grade 1. Okay, so that is those. Mini books to illustrate. And I put them, where did I put them? I put them in my center so I would have. So this is where you do a song and then you illustrate it. And I put lots of these in the lesson modules this year for teachers that weren't allowed to sing. They could listen to the song, the kids could talk about what the song was about, and then they got to illustrate it. So I'm going to screen share and we're going to do the song, My Aunt Came Back. It's just plain fun and I need a stretch. So we're going to go to the song list search and I'm going to look for My Aunt Came Back. And here it is. And we will do the lyrics. And I'm going to go full screen. So stand up. I want to see everybody in the gallery. Doing with me.
Oh, my aunt came back.
Oh, my aunt came back.
From Timbuktu.
From Timbuktu.
And, brought with her.
And brought with her.
A wooden shoe.
A wooden shoe.
Oh, my aunt came back.
Oh, my aunt came back.
From old Japan. And brought with her,
and brought with her,
a waving fan.
Oh,
my aunt came back.
Oh, my aunt came back
from old Algiers.
From old Algiers.
And brought with her,
and brought with her,
some pinking shears.
Some pinking shears.
Oh, my aunt came back.
Oh, my aunt came back
from Guadeloupe.
From Guadeloupe.
And brought with her. With her,
and brought with her,
a rocking chair,
a rocking chair.
Oh, my aunt came back.
Oh, my aunt came back
from the Calgary Zoo.
From the Calgary Zoo.
And brought with her,
and brought with her,
a nut like you.
A nut like you.
So, fun song. And I'm going to stop the screen sharing and show you what can be done with that. So, oh shoot, I went off the song too quick. I was going to show you, this is in the printables of the song, and you can download it. And then what you would have to do is, if you've got 20 kids in your class, you have to make sure you've got 20 sets of this. If you've got 3 grade 2 classes, make sure that you've got 60 printed out. These have to be in your sub tub for your sub to use, unless you know in advance that your sub's going to be able to buzz down to the office and somebody will make them a copy. And then what the kids do is they illustrate. Oh, my aunt came back from Timbuktu. They'll draw a picture that what that makes them think of. This one here is pretty long. It's got lots of pages for them to do. They might not finish it, and that's okay. They can take it home and they can finish it. For schools where there aren't a lot of books and reading materials in the homes where the kids live, these little books become a source of literature for the kids. And this is how I do it. I just cut them up and then assemble them and staple them. And honestly, if you're pushing into the classrooms, as so many teachers have done this year, and they're on a cart, I would get the kids to do the cutting and the assembly themselves. You can come around with the stapler and staple it, but then they can go home and they can sing the song to their mom. Oh, my aunt came back from Timbuktu. And that's it. And I saw in the chat going by that the kids love these little books. They do love them to take home. Honestly, for grade one, if you're following the music play lesson plans, there is a little book for almost every week of grade one. And this, of course, is the grade level where they're starting to read. And this is so important. I really actually hope we can make more of these because I think they're a really, really valuable tool. So this is in my grade two folder because it's a grade two song in my sub tub. So there's, I put in the handout, there's lots and lots of them. And what I would suggest, I put down a list of the ones that I think are the most familiar so that if your sub doesn't have technology, they can still do it. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. Almost every sub who walks into your room, I would say 99.9% of them are going to know that. They're going to know Wheels on the Bus. They're going to know 10 in the Bed. So those are good non-technology plans, non-singing plans, if we're not allowed to sing in the fall. So they can play the song to the kids. They can get the kids to do, to listen. And then they can create their illustration of the song. So another idea along this literacy aspect is to get the kids to make do-it-yourself big books. So I made up one for the song Doobie Doobie Doo, but again, let's do it. Let's experience the song first. And I'll remember this time to show you where you print it from. So I'm going to go into beta. I'm going to escape that. And I'm going to go to the song list. And I'm going to, I don't have to search for Doobie Doo because I know it's in grade one. And it's the very first song of grade one. And this is a really, really fun song. There's kids' demos if you don't remember how to do the movements. And here is the printable class book. Literally, I downloaded it, printed it myself. So stand up and let's do Doobie Doobie Doo and get everybody stretching out and
gonna clap my hands. Gonna clap my hands. All through the town. Gonna clap my hands. When the rain comes down. Gonna clap my hands. Like a funny clown. Gonna sing out loud. Till the cows come home. Gonna sing out loud. On the telephone. Gonna sing out loud. When I'm all alone. Gonna jump up and down. Jelly bean. Gonna jump up and down. Like a Mr. Clean. Gonna jump up and down. So I can be seen. Gonna stand on my toes. Get really tall. Gonna stand on my toes. Get really small. Gonna stand on my toes. It's better than my nose. Can I? All through the night. Gonna win, can I? Till I get it right. Gonna win, can I? With all my might. Gonna say bye-bye. Gonna see my gal. Gonna say bye-bye. Gonna see my pal.
I love that song. Kids love that song, which is more important. And this is what you can do with it. You print it out and it comes in, I'll stop sharing. Don't share. It comes in these 8.5 by 11 pages. If I'm okay with that size, fine. I can make a book. And when the kids have illustrated it, the lyrics are still large enough that you're going to be able to read it. But I really like a bigger size. So I enlarge it 130% onto 11 by 17 paper. And then I come up with a big book that I can put on a black stand and we can read and sing the song. This one perhaps isn't such a good reading song. The language level is above a little bit of the kids, but it's sure a fun one to sing and take part in. So let's look at some of the other ones. I gave you in your handout a list of examples that there are. So I'd Go Dancing is a really cute one. Again, it's in kindergarten. And this is one that a lot of teachers overlook until I actually do it in a workshop with them.
Gonna clap my hands.
We're gonna close down doobie-doo and we're gonna go to I'd Go Dancing. And here it is. And I made a teacher demo of it this year, so you would see the actions, but we're going to do the actions with me. So let's stand up and do this one. It's really cute. You actually don't even have to stand.
If I were a little gray mouse, I'd tiptoe through my people's house. And if all the cats were out of sight, well, I'd go dancing in the broad daylight. I would wear my top hat. And the fish. Na 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 na.
And if I were a big fat cat, I'd hide on the roof above the front door mat. And if all the dogs were out of sight, well, I'd go dancing in the broad.
Somebody's dog, I'd take my owner for a jog. And if all the trucks were out of sight, well, I'd go dancing in the broad daylight. I would wear my top hat and my cape and boogie woogie woogie down that lane. I would do the jitterbug, the jive and the twist, and then I'd do the monkey and the fish.
Cute kindergarten song that too few of you have found. And I'll stop sharing. I'll actually escape this first. And I'll stop sharing and show you again the big book for this. Copied all these off so I would have them. So here's I'd Go Dancing. This one is maybe a little bit better for predictable lyrics that the kids can read. If I were a little gray mouse, I tiptoe through my people's house. And you can always put the videos on a slower speed so you can track along with the recording if that's something you'd like to do. This one is, let me just check how many pages, 15 pages long. So what do you do if you've got more than 15 kids in a class? Well, my suggestion is you make two sets. One stays in the music room, one goes to the classroom teacher, and then they have an illustrated big book by the students in that class in their classroom library. If you have extras, you still have extras, put them in the library of the school and they can stay there until they fall apart. But they will be signed out and they will be well loved by the kids. They really love going through and finding the page that they illustrated. They really enjoy that. So I'd Go Dancing is a really good one. We did Doobie Doobie Doo. Another one that is a class favorite is I Am a Pizza. And this one, again, this is easy reading for the kids. So sing after me. I am a pizza with extra cheese. From tomatoes, sauce is squeezed. And it goes a little bit slower in tempo, the words repeat. So this is more realistic for the kids actually to be able to read as a big book. But I've always loved having big books in my classroom. If you go to Scholastic and you buy them, they're $40, $50, $60 to buy a really nice big book. This way, you get them for free because the school pays for the photocopying. And you're good to go. Let's do the I'm a pizza song. I think I've got time for everything that's on my list. So I'm going to look for I am a pizza. If I'm looking for the song list, I can go over to the left menu as well. The Discover list is going to search modules, listening, everything. But if I know it's a song I want, I just go to the song list. I am a pizza. You can tell I've searched it once already today. There it is. And this is a super fun song. And again, we've got some demos of it if you don't remember the lyrics or the movements. Start like this.
I am a pizza.
I am a pizza.
With extra cheese.
With extra cheese.
From tomatoes.
From tomatoes.
Sauce is squeezed.
Sauce is squeezed.
Onions and mushrooms.
Onions and mushrooms.
Oregano.
Oregano.
I am a pizza. Ready to go.
Oh,
I am a pizza.
I am a pizza.
Pepperoni.
Pepperoni.
No anchovies.
No anchovies.
Phony bologna.
Phony bologna.
I am a pizza.
I am a pizza.
Order by phone.
Order by phone.
I am a pizza. Please take me home. Oh, I am a pizza.
I am a pizza.
Peppers on top.
Peppers on top.
Out of the oven.
Out of the oven.
Into the box.
Into the box.
Into the car and.
Into the car and.
Upside down.
Upside down.
I am a pizza. Dropped on the ground.
I was a pizza.
I was the best.
I was the best.
I was a pizza. Now I'm a mess.
So find me a kid that doesn't like that song. They all do, and big kids like it too. So this is another kind of book that you can do. And right now I only have two. And they're actually not even on the site, but after this is over, Carrie Lynn's going to make a note for me. Denise, put them on the site because I've got the PDFs found now. My sister was a kindergarten teacher for a long, long time and a really good kindergarten teacher and used music in everything that she did. So she used a lot of our songs, and the song Take My Little Car for a Ride is in Musicplay for kindergarten. And she would teach the kids the song, get them all excited. It's a great song for teaching fast and slow. And then she would have each of her students, depending, she taught K and sometimes one. So for K, she would get them to tell what color their car was. My little car is blue. And the child would draw a car and make it a blue car. And then she would take all the pages from all the kids in the class, and she would coil them and make a class book out of this. So they could read what everybody's car was. And they could read that because my little car is. Those are all really, really simple words for your case. Now for her grade ones, she had them do a little bit more writing. I can take my little car, and they would write about where they would take it to and then draw a picture of it. So the grade one book has more writing, and the illustration would be of where they're going to take it to. If I'm going to take my little car to Disneyland, they would draw a picture of Disneyland. I'm going to take my little car to Grandma's house. They would draw a picture of Grandma's house. And she has a card template if you wanted to make a flip book out of it. But I actually think the first two options are exceptionally good. And again, this is something that you could leave for your sub. You could pre-teach the song or not. If you can tell the teacher how to search for it on beta, easy enough for the teacher to do it. You just tell them, go to the song list, type in the song name, and then we sing the song. So let's do my little car song. I found really fun ones for this week. I hope you're enjoying.
Yes, officer?
Could you slow down a little, please?
And again, that has been a class favorite forever. And I'll stop sharing. I copied so many things, I can't find the one page that I am looking for. Let's see. Oh, found it. Okay. So this is something new. This is something new. We had Ask Me pages on the site for kindergarten grade one. And what we're turning these into is illustrate. I wanted to stop sharing. Sorry, that's my bad. I wanted to turn these into illustrate the song with the same Ask Me information. So these would be great for a sub. The seesaw song is really simple. Seesaw up and down. In the air and on the ground. And again, they can go search for the song, but many, many kinder subs are gonna know that already. And if they just say the poem, that's okay too. So they would sing the song and then draw a picture of it. And then it goes home. And what it says at the top for the parents is, today in music class, I learned to sing the song Seesaw. Ask me to sing it to you. Invite me to sing the song to three people that I know. And at the bottom, there might be some extra little questions. Ask me to hold your hands and seesaw back and forth as I sing the song. And I should really show you my twin granddaughters doing seesaw because they made up some really fun actions for it. They made up their own movements as well. But you can go search that out on the beta site after. So I wanted to make sure I did leave us some time for question and answers. Are there any questions in the chat, Carrie Lynn, that I should be answering?
Yeah, what about access to Musicplay Online?
Okay, so the beta site as of July 1st, is going to require a teacher account, which means it's going back to subscription. It's going to, as of July 1st, it's going to cost $175 a year in American dollars and $200 a year in Canadian dollars. Or you can, I think there is still the monthly option. Am I correct, Carrie Lynn?
Yes. Yep.
Yes. So two lunches out a month, or you have access to everything on the website. I think it's a pretty good deal. With that access comes student access for all of your students. Many, many, many websites that are built for teachers include student access at a per student cost. We don't. We include student access for everybody in your school. We do have a cap because some virtual schools have many thousands of kids. So we do have a cap on it. But basically, any of you who teach in a school 1,000 kids or less, you'll have access for all of your students. And then when you get that code, you can give that code to your substitute and they can use it certainly for the day. And I don't really mind if they use it a couple of times after. They'll probably forget after they've been in your classroom. But yes, the beta will require an account, and the musicplayonline.com as of July 1st is going to require an account. We did from 2016 until COVID hit. And then from COVID until now, while schools were locked down, we gave free access, free student access. So we know people have been enjoying that and using it, but we have a pretty big staff to pay and they would like paychecks. So we have to make sure that the site stays sustainable. Okay, more questions.
So when you have something in the sub tub, is it, should you be showing it before you put it into your sub tub or let the sub introduce it?
That's going to depend on the activity. If it's something that's going to need pre-teaching, then pre-teach. You're going to have to make that judgment call. But typically I'm going to put something in that sub tub that my, that a sub could do. I mean, if I'm gone for a week, if, you know, all of a sudden I have to get my appendix out or emergency gallbladder surgery, I want something in there that's going to be usable for an entire week. And that's where these particular activities are good. I can pre-teach them and I would pre-teach the singing games that are here, but you don't have to pre-teach the fun songs and things like that. Centers depends on the complexity of the center. Scales and slides game, that's really easy. I think a sub could do that. Some of the others, I would say, maybe they do need some pre-teaching. But again, I've only got one sub tub because I guest teach. I think you're probably going to need maybe one for your K1s, one for your 2-3s, one for your 4-5s, because this will fill up fast if you're putting in 60 copies of something. Okay, more questions.
Perfect. Yeah, we've got a bunch in the chat, but before we jump into the chat, if you teach at two schools, does your subscription cover student access at both schools?
If you personally are the teacher in two schools, yes, we cover both schools.
Awesome. Alrighty, and
it's a good deal.
Yeah. Okay, so in the chat, Elizabeth is asking, what are some ideas for teaching asynchronously?
Asynchronously is more difficult. Asynchronously, you know what I would do? I would give them a link to the lesson module and I would have the kids work through that lesson module themselves. Pre-K, K1s are going to absolutely need parent help. When we first went on lockdown in March 2020, I ended up homeschooling four grandchildren for the better part of a week. And oh my goodness, it was hard. The boys were just fine on their own. I could give them work and they were good. But the girls were grade one and couldn't read at a level to make it through the lesson without my help. So I think asynchronous lessons, I think there has to be an expectation that parents are going to assist somewhat with them. Yes, and no technology is another issue altogether. I did put a set of pre-K non-tech lessons. Carrie Lynn, are those in lesson planning?
That's a really good question. I will check it. And if they aren't, I will add them.
Yeah, they were quite beautiful. And those pre-K lessons could probably be used by pre-K, K, grade one. And they were things that no technology was required for. Things like filling water glasses, different sizes, and seeing which was the lowest and which was the highest. They were actually really, really, really good lessons. So we'll find those and we'll add those to the substitute lesson plans. Let's add them to pre-K, K, and one. That set of lessons. There's 9 lessons there. So that should take our asynchronous teachers quite far.
Perfect. Tech question, will the student code ever change?
If you maintain your subscription, it will not change. Originally, when we did the student login, we were sort of doing it as a regular login, and to prevent people abusing it, we changed it every 3 months. That's gone. Now the student code is yours until you retire, which will be sooner than me.
Do you want to talk a little bit about Artie and Denise and the discount that people get for Musicplay Online?
Yes. So when you do the Artie and Denise sign up first. So if you do the Artie and Denise sign up, you get a welcome package, and that welcome package includes a 25% off code. And you can either use it to renew your subscription on Musicplay Online. Correct me if I'm wrong, Carrie Lynn.
Yep, 100%.
Okay, stay unmuted because you might need to help me here. Or one of our store sites, and you can use that code to purchase. Honestly, that code, that 25% off is a deal, because if you actually wanted 2 or 3 teacher's guides, they cost over $100 each and you'd get them for 25% off. If I share screen, I will show you how to get to our store sites. I don't know why my email keeps popping up here. This is embarrassing. You don't need to see my email or my busy calendar. Let's go to MusicPlay. I'm going to musicplay.ca. And if you're a Canadian teacher, you click here. If you're a US teacher, you click here. If you just want the online site, you click here. I have to go to Canada because it automatically defaults to what country I happen to be in. But I can go here, and then if I sign up for the conference, I will get that welcome package by email. How soon, Carrie Lynn? Will it come out automatically?
Yes, it will, as soon as they're added to the list. Yep.
Okay, as soon as you're added to the list, it comes out. And then you can click here to purchase a Musicplay subscription. So if you're buying it for the very first time,
your account may not work because you have an administrator account.
Okay, so I won't show you this, but you should be able to go through the process and use it there. Or you can use it for anything that's on here. I think we might need to, if you want to use it for a bunch of things and the online site, it might be best if you do that by emailing your order to sales@musicplay.ca, because I think it's not going to work through here.
Unless you were to go to the school order and hit that credit card, then it's the original Musicplay Online.
They wouldn't be able to add anything to it and get the discount off it.
The discount is applied on the cart. So whatever they add to the cart will be discounted.
Oh, okay. So this is how we do it then. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you would go ahead and sign up, add it to your cart, and then you could go shopping. And
exactly.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So that is the way to use the discount for the subscription and for a bunch of other things.
Yep.
Okay.
But the discount code does work if you're just on Musicplay Online. It does also work. Yeah.
Okay. More questions before I pop off sharing.
Okay. 12-week maternity leave, teacher login given to the sub, is that okay?
I would say yes. Yeah, I would say yes. Let's make it easy for the new mums, as easy for the new mums as we can, because that's really hard, only getting a 12-week maternity leave. I had 8 weeks with my third one, and I'll tell you, it was awful. My daughter had a year and a half with her second. Didn't get paid for the whole time, but that's what you're guaranteed in Canada. So we're lucky, fortunate.
Yeah.
We pay for it in our taxes, but we're lucky.
Yeah. So there's a question here to prove that we attended this webinar. Can Shannon or Karis post the professional development certificate in the chat so that people can use that? What about the YouTube video list that you talked about on Facebook?
Haven't built it yet. We've had a busy week.
Yeah, Seriously,
Busy. I will just tell you what happened. We got offered a grant to hire an additional programmer, and you're not going to say no to that. So everything else kind of got shoved to the side, and we got this grant application. We posted the job and found someone and hired him about 2 hours ago. So that's kind of taken. So I've got a couple of days. I'm going to aim to have that YouTube video list in the modules, and it'll be in general. And I'll probably do one for younger and one for older. And I will probably have one that's around 30 minute and one that's around 60 minute, because I think that's probably what more, there's so many links. We were given over 100 good suggestions. And I know there's even more than that. Another thing for subs that I didn't mention is we are this close to owning the rights to put the composer videos on our website. Those are 50 minute videos. We will be making worksheets and a whole unit to build around them. But what better plan for grade 4, 5, 6 kids than to watch Bizet's Dream, Rossini's Ghost, Beethoven Lives Upstairs, Handel's Last Chance. And those are all wonderful, wonderful videos with lots of really, really good educational content. I have no problems justifying the use of them as a teacher. It's not just watching cartoons. It's watching some really good stuff. I don't know if it's going to be done by Friday, but I'll be posting about it when it is done. It's been 6-7 months of negotiations to get this. So I'm very, very happy that we're that close. And they will be in English, French, and Spanish. So Beethoven Lives Upstairs is only, I think it's English and French, but the other three, the other six are English, French, and Spanish. So for our French schools, for our Spanish schools, we have 6 hours of good content coming for you.
Perfect. Yeah, okay, and I just want to fire through some of these questions. There will be a recording of this session. It'll be posted on YouTube when the processing is finished. It'll also be posted on Musicplay Online with a handout and then the list of everything that was mentioned in this session.
And the Musicplay Online webinars are in the dashboard announcements, mm-hmm. is where you'll find them. And then if you've missed other webinars, you can go back and you can get your certificates from those other webinars.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Yes. And if you've already purchased your renewal and you have a discount code, you can always purchase an additional year for next year. The discount code does expire. I'm not entirely sure when it does. I think at the end of December. So yeah, you have time to plan your cart. That is good. Okay, any other questions? Just rolling. I did want to mention one thing. Somebody asked if there was going to be a sub account attached to a teacher account that would get preferred access to Musicplay Online in the way that you want.
That's funny.
Yeah, it's on our list. So thank you. Okay.
That's sorry. Why we need a second programmer.
Literally.
Programmer, so we can get these jobs done quicker.
Okay. Good. Okay. And I think that is everything. Anything else from anybody else?
Okay. Hi. I'm sorry. I had a question in the chat. Thank you so much for this. This has been awesome. My students would love to continue to work through Musicplay over the summer, and they've asked me about it. I'm wondering if I remain a member over the summer, can I share the code and make sure they, like, can I just offer the code to anybody who wants it?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Give it to your kids. We want them on the site using it. And there will be new games going up over the summer. We've got one of our developers. He's one who built the trivia wheel, and
the trivia wheel has been the biggest hit of and the gift to my life. I'll tell you, it's been fantastic.
We will pass
love
on
it.
He will be delighted, and there will be new levels added to the trivia wheel. So new games. The possibilities are absolutely endless. In fact, if you have questions for us, send us a list of questions. We'll put them on. that goes for anybody. But yeah, no, those games are great and keep your kids' musical skills up. And they're absolutely welcome to use the site over the summer. Encourage it.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, and then just about the discount code for Artie and Denise, it is available in the welcome package. If you have signed up for Artie and Denise and you haven't received the welcome package, please send me an email or send an email to sales. That is the way that we get access to you. So please reach out to us immediately.
I would suggest sending the email to support@musicplay.ca.
Okay.
That's where I've been suggesting is support@musicplay.ca. Yeah, we want everybody to have that welcome package for sure.
Yeah, definitely. Got some good stuff in there.
We're really excited about this. It's going to be a wonderful conference. And we did this with Zoom and we did these webinars with Zoom, so we would get a little bit of practice. And I have to say, I'm still learning, but hopefully by Artie and Denise, I'll have a better idea of how to do sessions over Zoom. It's you've done more of them this year than I've done. And so I am still a learner in this area. But thank you so much for coming and sharing your after school time with us. We really appreciate you.
Perfect. Thank you so much, everybody.